now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Thank you. Shalom, from Babylon to the rest of the world, my soul has been freed, for all the time. My flesh is torn down to the end, and my prayer is torn to book. So in the sanctuary, I have been before you to see that power in my Lord. But my mercy is better than my sin, and shall praise thee, so shall I bless thee in my blood. And in any way lift up my hands, as with my own fatness, let my soul be filled. And if there's rejoicing, shall I not be praised thee? If I remember thee on my bed, the dawn of that day, I'll leave the hour of the night, and shall fill my room with lavishness. My soul hath made up for thee, though I have had it with thou. But as for the reason they have then sought after my soul, they shall go unto the head of those parts, and they shall be surrendered unto the end of the sword. Washings for foxes shall be thee, but the king shall be glad, and God, everyone shall be praised that strive by him. For the mouth of them is soft that speak unjust things. The dawn of that day, I'll leave the night, and I'll come home from the shelter of my room to where I rejoice. My soul hath made up for thee, though I have had it with thou. Voice of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, will now and ever, and to the ages of the ages, amen. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Lord, mercy, Lord, mercy, Lord, mercy, glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
Both now and ever, and to the ages of the ages, amen. O Lord God of my salvation, my name, my pride, my name before thee, let my prayer come before thee, bow down thine ear to my supplication. For filled with evils is my soul and my life, and the Hades hath drawn nigh. I am come to with them that go down into the pit. I because come as a man without power, praying on the dead, like the bodies of the slain that sleep in the grave, and thou rememberest no more, and they are cut off from thy hand. They lead me in the lowest pit in darkness and in the shadow of death. Against me is thine anger made strong, and all thy billows hast thou brought upon me. Thou hast removed my friends apart from me. They have made me an abomination unto themselves. I have been delivered up and have not come forth. Mine eyes have grown weak from poverty. I have cried unto thee, O Lord, the whole day long. I have stretched out my hands unto thee. Nay, for the dead wilt thou work wonders, or show physicians grace and love that they may give thanks unto thee. Nay, shall any of the grave tell of thy mercy and of thy truth and thy destruction. Nay, shall thy wonders be known in that darkness and that righteousness in that land that is forgotten. But as for me unto thee, O Lord, and I cry, and in the morning shall my prayer come before thee. Wherefore, O Lord, didst thou cast off my soul and turnest away thy face from me? A poor man am I, and troubles from my youth, yea, having been exalted, I was humbled and brought to distress. Of thy cares have passed upon me, and thy cares have sorely troubled me. They came round about me like water all day long, they compassed me about together. Thou hast removed apart from me, from the neighbor and my acquaintances, because of my misery. O Lord God of my salvation, my day have I cried, my hand before thee. Let my prayer come before thee, bow down thine ear to my supplication. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within thee, bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all that he hath done for thee, who is gracious unto all thine iniquities, and healeth all thine infirmities, who redeemeth thy life from corruption, and crowneth thee with mercy and compassion, who fulfilleth thy desire with good things, that you should hear against the eagles. The Lord performeth deeds of mercy, and executeth judgment for all them that are wrong. Yet made his ways known unto Moses and to the sons of Israel, the things he hath loved. Compassionate and merciful is the Lord, long suffering and plenteous in mercy. Not unto thee, and will he be angry, neither unto infinity, will he be wroth. Not according to our iniquities, that he yield with us, neither according to our sins, that he rewarded us. Or according to the height of heaven from the earth, the Lord hath made his mercy prevail over them that fear him. As far as the east is from the west, so far hath he removed iniquities from us. Like as the Father hath compassion upon his Son, so the Lord hath compassion upon him and for him. For he knoweth where we are made, and remembereth that we are dust. As for man's days, so is the grass, as the flower of the field, so shall he blossom forth. For when the wind is passed over, then it shall be gone, and no longer will it ever place thereof. But the mercy of the Lord is from eternity, even unto eternity upon him and for him. And his righteousness is upon the sons of the Son, upon him that he possesseth him, and remember his commandments to do them. The Lord in heaven hath prepared his throne, and the kingdom will come for all. Bless the Lord, all his angels, mighty and strength, that perform his words, and hear the voice of his words. Bless the Lord, all his hosts, and ministers, that do his will. Bless the Lord, all his works, and every place of his dominion. Bless the Lord, all my soul, and every place of his dominion. Bless the Lord, all my soul. O Lord, hear my prayer, give ear to my supplication, and thy truth. Hearken unto me thy righteousness, and as in thy strength with thy servant. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. O our God and our hope, glory to thee.
In peace let us pray to the Lord. Peace from above and for the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace of the whole world, for the good estate of the holy churches of God, and for the union of all men, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this holy house and for those who with faith, reverence, and the fear of God enter therein, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our Father, Metropolitan Joseph, for the venerable priesthood, the diaconate in Christ, for all the clergy and the people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For Metropolitan Paul and Archbishop John, and for their quick release from captivity and safe return, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the President of the United States, for all civil authorities and foreign forces everywhere, especially for Peter, Joshua, Ronnie, Adam, Andrew, Benjamin, Thaddeus, Skyler, Tristan, and Connor, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
this city and for every city and land, and for the faithful who dwell therein, let us pray to the
Lord.
For healthful seasons and for the abundance of the fruits of the earth and for peaceful times, let us pray to the
Lord.
For travelers by sea, by land, and by air, for the sick and the suffering, for captives and for their salvation, for those under persecution for the faith, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our deliverance from all tribulation, wrath, danger, necessity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace. Calling to remembrance our all holy and immaculate, most blessed and glorious Lady, the Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God. For
unto thee are due all glory, honor, and worship to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Oh.
again in peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Calling to remembrance our all holy, immaculate, most blessed and glorious Elizabeth, and the Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other, and all our life, unto Christ our God.
Thank you.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Calling to remembrance our all holy, immaculate, most blessed, and
glorious Lady of the
Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God. Counted worthy to hear the holy gospel, let us pray to the Lord God.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Wisdom, stand upright, let us hear the holy gospel.
Peace be to all.
And to thy spirit.
Reading from the holy gospel according to St. Luke.
Glory to thee, O Lord.
Attentive.
On the first day of the week at early dawn, the women went others with them. And they found the stone rolled away from the tomb. But when they looked in, they did not find the body of the Lord Jesus. While they were perplexed about this, behold, two men stood by them in dazzling apparel. And as they were frightened and bowed their faces to the ground, the men said to them, "Why do you seek the living among the dead? He is not here, but is risen. Remember how he told you while he was still in Galilee that the Son of Man must be delivered into the hands of sinful men and be crucified, and on the third day rise again." And they remembered his words. And returning from the tomb, they told all this to the 11 and to all the rest. Now it was Mary Magdalene and Joanna and Mary the mother of James and the other women with them who told this to the apostles. But these words seemed to them an idle tale, and they did not believe them. But Peter rose and ran to the tomb, stooping and looking in. He saw the linen cloths by themselves, and he departed, wondering at what had happened.
Glory to thee, O Lord, glory to thee.
In that we have beheld the resurrection of Christ, let us bow down before the Holy, before Jesus, the only sinless one, that cross we have torn with Christ, and that one of us shall be praised and glorified. For thou art our God, and we know none other beside thee. We call upon thy name, O come, O ye faithful, at the door of Christ's holy resurrection. For lo, the cross is joy coming to all the world. God bless the Lord, let us sing his resurrection. For in that he endured the cross for us, he hath destroyed death by death.
Have mercy on me, O God, according to thy great mercy, and according to the multitude of thy kindness, and blot out my transgression. Wash me thoroughly from my iniquity, and cleanse me from my sin. For I know my iniquity and my sin is ever before me. Against thee only have I sinned and done this evil before thee, that thou mightest be justified in thy works and prevail when thou art judged. For behold, I was conceived in iniquity, and sin did my mother bear me. For behold, thou hast dealt truthfully, and did it in secret things with thy wisdom, as thou made manifest unto me. Thou shalt sprinkle me with hyssop, and I shall be made clean. Thou shalt wash me, and I shall be made white as snow. Thou shalt make me to hear joy and gladness, the bones that be humble, they shall rejoice. Turn thy face away from my sins, and blot out all my iniquities. Grant me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. Cast me not away from thy presence, and take not thy Holy Spirit from me. Restore to me the joy of thy salvation, when thy governing spirit established me. I shall teach transgressors thy ways, and even godly shall turn back unto thee. Deliver me from blood guiltiness, O God, the God of my salvation, my tongue shall rejoice in thy righteousness. O Lord, thou shalt open my lips, and my mouth shall declare thy praise. For if thou hast desired sacrifice, I have given it. With whole burnt offerings thou shalt not be pleased. A sacrifice unto God is a broken spirit, a heart that is broken, humble God will not despise. Do good alone and every pleasure in Zion, and under the walls of Jerusalem be built up. Then shalt thou be pleased with the sacrifice of righteousness. With oblation and whole burnt offerings, then shall they offer holiness upon thine altar.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, through the intercessions of the apostles of thou who art merciful, pour out all the multitude of our transgressions.
Both now and ever, and unto ages of ages, amen.
Through the intercessions of the
thy world with mercy and compassion, exalt the horn of Orthodox Christians, and send down upon us thy rich mercies. Through the intercessions of all Immaculate Lady the Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary, as we celebrate the placing of her robe in black linen on this day, by the might of the precious and life-giving cross, by the protection of the honorable bodiless powers of heaven, at the supplication of the honorable glorious prophet, forerunner and baptist John, of the holy glorious and laudable apostles Peter and Paul, and of all the holy apostles, of our fathers among the saints, great hierarchs and ecumenical teachers, Basil the Great, Gregory the Theologian, and John Chrysostom, Athanasius, Kirill and John the Merciful, who were the patriarchs of Alexandria, Nicholas of Myra, Spirit and Achimithos, and Nectarius of Pentapolis, who were the wonder workers, of our fathers among the saints, Tikhon, patriarch of Moscow, and Raphael, the Bishop of Brooklyn, of the holy, glorious, great martyrs, George the Trophy Bearer, Demetrios the Mirror Streamer, Theodore the Soldier, Theodore the General, and Minas the Wonder Worker, of the higher martyrs, Ignatius, the God-bearer of Antioch, Harlamos and Eleftherios, of the holy, glorious, great women martyrs, Thecla, Barbara, Anastasia, Catherine, Kiriaki, Fotini, Marina, Haresca, and Irene, of the holy, glorious, great victorious martyrs, of our venerable and God-bearing fathers, as shown in the ascetic life, Antony the Great, Seraphim of Sarov, and Herman of Alaska, of the laudable apostle Barnabas, the patron and protector of this holy community, of the holy and righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, of our father among the saints, Juvenali, Archbishop of Jerusalem, the new martyrs of Samothrace, and Archbishop John Maximovich, the wonderworker of Shanghai and San Francisco, whose memory we celebrate today, and Joe, the first patriarch of Moscow, whose repose we commemorate today, and of all the saints who beseech thee, O most merciful Lord, hearken unto the petition of us sinners who make our supplications unto thee, and have mercy upon us.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Jaya Puram, Jaya Puram, Jaya Puram. Kyele Sam, Kyele Sam, Kyele Sam. Gospodi pomiloj, Gospodi pomiloj, Gospodi pomiloj.
Through the mercy, compassion, and love for mankind, of thine only begotten Son, whom thou art blessed, together with thine awfully good and life-giving Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
I shall be seen joyfully singing your praises, and I shall be
mercy on us and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Calling to remembrance our all holy Immaculate, most blessed and glorious Lady of the Altar, and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God.
Oh, yeah.
Oh,
Of our souls, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace of the whole world, for the good estate of the holy churches of God, and for the union of all men, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this holy house, and for those with faith, reverence, and the fear of God enter therein, let us pray to the Lord. For our Father, Metropolitan Joseph, for the Venerable Priesthood, the Diaconate in Christ, for all the clergy and the people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For Metropolitan Paul and Archbishop John, and for their quick release from captivity and safe return, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the President of the United States, for all civil authorities, and for our forces everywhere, especially for Peter, Joshua, Ronnie, Adam, Benjamin, Andrew, Thaddeus, Skyler, and Connor, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this city and for every city and land, and for the faithful who dwell therein, for healthful seasons, for abundance of the fruits of the earth, and for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For travelers by sea, by land, and by air, for the sick and the suffering, for captives and for their salvation, for those under persecution for the faith, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our deliverance from all tribulation, wrath, danger, necessity, help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Calling to remembrance our all holy, immaculate, most blessed and glorious Lady of the Apostles, and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God.
Now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Christ our God, trampling down death by death. Who art one of the Holy Trinity, glorified with the Father and the Holy Spirit, save us.
Again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Calling to remembrance our all holy, immaculate, most blessed and glorious Lady, the filled Tobos, and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God.
To sing unto
Oh, soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for he has regarded the humility of his servant.
Wisdom.
The reading is from St. Paul's letter to the Hebrews.
Let us attend.
Brethren, the first covenant had regulations for worship and an earthly sanctuary. For a tent was prepared, the outer one, in which the lampstands and the table and the bread of the presence. It is called the holy place. Behind the second curtain stood a tent called the Holy of Holies, having the golden altar of incense and the Ark of the Covenant, covered on all sides with gold, which contained a gold urn holding the manna, Aaron's rod that budded, and the tables of the covenant. Above it were the cherubim of glory, overshadowing the mercy seat. Of these things we cannot now speak in detail. These preparations have thus been made. The priests go continually in the outer tent, performing their ritual duties. But into the second only the high priest goes, and he but once a year, and not without taking blood which he offered for himself and for the errors of the people.
Peace be to thee, as he is.
Traced back to a word which means a mask, So the human person, as they describe him, is a mask, and beyond it is undefinable and kind of a void, and there's nothing there. And all we see on the outside is a mask, and all we can describe of the anthropos, of the human person, is that mask, which is a shell, and it's something that is not very, it's very transitory, right? And the fathers, the only time they use the word person is to talk about God, and God dwelling within his saints. So to become a true human person is to have God dwell within us. And that only comes through our asceticism, our drawing closer to God through prayer, through fasting, and the sacraments of the church. But the saints paved this way for us to come from being a mask to being a human person, to having God dwell within us. And today, and yesterday in the evening, we celebrated the feast of St. John the Wonder Worker, who is a saint that was among us, that walked our soil, that lived in our crazy society. And yet, it says in the Troparion to him that he became like the saints of old. So we read about all these saints that lived in the past, yet he was one of them, but lived in our world today. And he's very relatable to us in a lot of ways, because he became that human person, that true human person that we talked about, because God dwelt within him. And he paved that way through asceticism. And many times, we think that ascetics and monastics and people who live without being married and things like that, that their asceticism and their struggle is much different than ours and maybe not so relatable to us. But one thing we kind of forget about with St. John is that all of the things that we know about him, that he didn't sleep at night because he prayed all the time, because he gave the shoes to the poor, all of these different ascetic things that he did for his love of God, one thing stands out the most of all of them, and that is that he was a father to children. He became a father to people who didn't have fathers. And he embraced the childlike faith in behalf of the children that he looked after and took care of and raised. So his asceticism, a lot of the time, was for children, was for raising children, which a lot of us do. And so this saint that might seem so far away from us not only lived in our world, but raised children like many of us do. And he did these ascetic works and drew close to God on behalf of his children, so that his children would also grow close to God and that he would give them the grace of God. So being around these children, he embraced sort of a childlike faith, and that childlike faith rubbed off on him. And out of the mouths of babes and sucklings, we know comes perfected praise. So praise was made perfect in St. John through his love for his children and through his asceticism on behalf of his children. There's a very beautiful story, and if any of you ever get the blessing to visit San Francisco and go to St. Tikhon's house, which is the orphanage that he brought all the children from Shanghai to the Philippines and to San Francisco, if you ever go to that house, there's a small church that he built with inside the living room of that house for his orphans. And it's still there to this day, and it actually functions as a parish. There's people that go there every Sunday for liturgy. And there's a small icon to the side of that chapel, and it's of the Mother of God, the Milk Giver. So it's an icon of the Theotokos breastfeeding Christ. Whenever the orphanage would run out of supplies for food, he would gather all of the children in front of that icon. They would pray in front of that icon, and after they were done with their prayers, there was always a ring on the doorbell with somebody that had donations and food and things like that. So he didn't stress about what they're going to do next, but he had childlike faith, and he knew that God would provide for him whenever and wherever he was, especially on behalf of his children. And it's very relatable to the gospel story that we read today, because we read of a centurion who, this is after Christ gave the Sermon on the Mount, and he's descending from the mount. This centurion came to him privately and asked him to grant healing to a family member that was not around, right? He was at the centurion's house. The person was at the centurion's house, the family member. And instead of asking Christ to come to the house to heal the person, he just believed that Christ could do it from wherever he's at. And because he commands all the angels. And this childlike faith, he didn't think that God had to be at a specific place, at a specific time, to grant healing. Even with Jacob in his lap and the ladder, when he saw the angels ascending and descending from the ladder, he said, God is right here. He built an altar right here. And he said, God is here. This is the holy place. And even Moses, when he was at the burning bush, that this is the holy place. The centurion didn't say, Christ is a holy man, therefore he needs to be at a certain place in order for us to receive revelation or to receive healing or miracles. But that Christ could be anywhere at all times and still perform these miracles. So Christ marveled at his faith and said that there is no one in Israel that he's found like this centurion man who believed that Christ can just heal from wherever he is at. This childlike faith that he had in God to heal his beloved from wherever he is. So even if it seems like Christ is far away from us many times, he is always there to heal us. It's very beautiful that the evangelists in the gospel many times do not say, when Christ appears in a crowd or something like that, they don't actually use the word Christ appeared, but that Christ revealed himself. And it's very beautiful in the difference between these two words. Christ appeared means that Christ comes into our midst, and he appears like somebody just came into a room or out of the door. He appears like he was hidden somewhere and he came. But the evangelists use the word, many times they use the word revealed, which means that Christ is there always and always can be seen. But many of the time, much of the time, it's up to us to look for him. And when we look for him, that's when he is revealed. So even if Christ is far away from us, when we look for him with childlike faith, he reveals himself to us. And he heals us from wherever he is and in whatever condition that we're in. And not only just our physical diseases that we care a lot about, but also our spiritual state and our spiritual diseases. So it's a very beautiful thing to look to the lives of these saints who are the brothers of our church, that exemplify this healing and this love toward God, and see things in our life that relate to us, like St. John with his child rearing and his childlike faith and humility. So childlike faith heals us of our own diseases of both soul and body when we call upon God, even if we feel like he is far away. And he will come to us and heal us when we have the faith of the centurion. So through the prayers of St. John Maximovich, may we assume the purity of heart of children and the faith and prayer of children, that we may enter the kingdom of heaven and dine with our fathers Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, through the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Help us, save us, have mercy upon us. Keep us, O God, by thy grace, wisdom.
Thy heart is always by thy might be ascribed glory unto thee, through the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
God remember his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Remember them in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
For Metropolitan Paul and Archbishop John, for their quick release from captivity and safe return, the Lord God remember them in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages. The Orthodox servants of God, especially for Krierlin and for Priest Wayne, for Bonnie, Pauline, Elias, Penelope, Tim, Sue, Michael, Tatiana, Serena, for the Priest John and the Priest Andrew and their families, for Taylor, Stephanie, Caitlin, Kelsey, Lauren, Laurie, Christina, Michelle, Claire, Mary, Eli, and the Rome family, that they have mercy, life, peace, health, salvation, visitation, pardon, and remission of their sins. The Lord God remember them in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages.
The Orthodox servants of God departed this life in the hope of resurrection and life eternal, especially for His Eminence the Metropolitan Andonios, for Howard, for Ivana, for Lorraine, and for the Korea Stephanie, the Proto-Priest, for Presbyter Peter, the Proto-Deacon, Gregory, for William, and for George and Wilma. The Lord God remember them in His kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Repentance,
for a Christian into our life, painless, blameless, peaceful, and a good defense before the awesome judgment seat of Christ. Let us have
this, O Lord,
calling to remembrance our all holy immaculate, most blessed and glorious Lady Theotokos, and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints. Let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God. That with one accord we may confess.
Thanks.
unto thee and to thine only begotten Son and thy Holy Spirit, for all things of which we know and of which we know not, and for all the benefits bestowed upon us, both manifest and unseen. And we give thanks unto thee also for this ministry, which thou hast received our hands, even unto standing beside thee, thousands of our angels, and the thousands of angels, the cherubim and the seraphim, six-winged, many-eyed, soaring aloft, going on their knees, singing the triumphal hymn, shouting, proclaiming, and saying,
thank you.
Jesus Christ be with you all.
I believe, O Lord, and
remission of my sins, and unto life everlasting. Amen. Have then the sixth supper, O Son of God, and accept me today as the communion, for I will not speak of thy mysteries to thine enemies. Neither will I give thee a kiss as to Judas, but like with thee will I confess thee. Remember me, O Lord, in thy kingdom, not in judgment, nor in condemnation. Be my partaking of thy holy mysteries, O Lord, and as the healing of soul and body.
Thank you.
save thy people and bless thine inheritance.
Ages.
Amen.
come and our hope, glory to thee.
Glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Our true God, through the intercessions of His all-immaculate and all-blameless Holy Mother, as we celebrate the placing of her robe and black grenade on this day, by the might of the precious and life-giving cross, by the protection of the honorable, bodiless powers of heaven, at the supplication of the honorable, glorious prophet, forerunner at Baptist John, of the holy, glorious, and all-laudable apostles, of our Father among the saints, John Chrysostom, Archbishop of Constantinople, whose divine liturgy we have now celebrated, of the holy, glorious, and right victorious martyrs, of our venerable and God-bearing fathers, of Saint Barnabas, the patron and protector of this holy community, of the holy and righteous ancestors of God who came in Adam, of our father among the saints, Juvenali, Archbishop of Jerusalem, the new martyrs of Samothrace, and Archbishop John Maximovich, the wonder worker of Shanghai and San Francisco, whose memory we celebrate today, and Job, the first patriarch of Moscow, whose repose we commemorate today, and of all the saints, have mercy upon us and save us, for as much as he is good and loves us mankind. The prayers of our holy fathers, Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy on us and save us.
Amen.
Take a look at the bulletin, because it's very, very different this week. Divine liturgy, divine liturgy, divine liturgy, cancel, cancel, so on. Because of the Parish Life Conference and because of our two very bright, do we still have two or did I just hang on? I'll be back. Okay, good. What, I'm getting spoiled with having a couple of store-bought priests around, you know, instead of this whole homemade jobs. These guys really know their stuff. Very inspirational. Don't be spoiled when they leave, I don't know what. But they are doing divine liturgy, as you can see, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, 6 a.m. in the morning. And that's convenient for people who are on their way to work, perhaps, you know, and want to stop off and have prayer. I understand it's growing in popularity, so it's cool. It is possible. I was stunned that there's such a thing as 6 o'clock in the morning. And because of the Parish Life Conference this week, which starts the 5th of July, we won't be having services here during the week, except for the morning liturgies, and nor in North County, so that, you know, be free to go to the events in Los Angeles at the PLC. But we will have normal Orthodox and liturgy next Sunday. So we will be open for that. If some rumors are going around that we might be closed next Sunday, we will not be closed. We will be open for business. And, I mean, you know, we gotta film these things and put them on YouTube so people know that it's going around. And by the way, have you noticed that? We are on YouTube now. All of our services are being filmed or taped or videoed or whatever you call it these days, and put on YouTube. And you know, I always watch, well, you know, I watch my own homilies, so I learned what I said, and I found out some terrible things about myself, like, I say you know a lot, you know, it's like, shut that guy to love microphones because I thought the only thing better than the sound of my voice is the sound of my voice louder. But I was wrong. Do we have any other announcements from parish council? Anybody? Have they got a garage sale they want to talk about? In that case, we're welcome to come forward for the veneration of the whole course.
Glory to you, O God.